Hi guys, welcome back to another video. And then on today's video, we're going to be talking about the candlestick formations that I always trade, a few patterns that I trade, and then I'm going to share them with you guys. Just watch up until the end. I'm going to give you like a picture perfect scenario, and then I'm going to give you on the live chats and show you like how I use them like on the live chats. So on this area here, we have the bullish engulfing. As you all know, a bullish engulfing is a candlestick formation to push to the upside. So let's say the market has been dropping to the downside, for it to reach like some type of an area whereby you are anticipating to take like those buying opportunities. And then let me just do this. Then let's say the market has been pushing to the downside, or let me just do this and clone this one here. We have been pushing to the downside for some quite a while on this type of price action, and then we expect the market to reach a certain level. Let me just change that to a normal color like this, and then we expect the market to reach like a certain level whereby this is a double bottom area, or it's an override area depending on the type of strategy that you are using. Let's say we have the double bottom like this. And then that's the area that you're looking to buy. And then what you do is that you wait for this candle here to close, this red candle to close. Let's say we are in this type of area. This candle is still forming up. So when it's around this point, you don't take the trade. You wait up until it engulfs this overall red candle, and then you have this overall green candle overriding the overall price of this red candle. And then that is where you take your long around this point after the candle close. And then it does not mean that you'll have like a big stop loss like this one. This is a picture perfect setup, like I said. And then you anticipate to take like the trade to the upside depending on the level. Maybe you take as prof take profit. Let's say you take profit around this point, then you take your take profit. So in this scenario, you have like 1.3%, so it's fine. You take your trade here, and then you expect the market to clearly push to the upside. Just like this, you expect the market to push to the upside up until you hit take profit. Oh, sorry about that. Up until you hit take profit, just like this. So this is the candlestick formation that I use. And then on the second one, we have the bearish engulfing, of which it's in reverse to this one. On this one, you get like momentum pushing to the upside. And then after the momentum pushes to the upside, you'll get that you have this type of price action at the top of the structure, knowing that you have an value area at the top of the structure. And then, like I said, on this bullish engulfing, guys, you wait for the market to close. Let's say it's around this point. You just wait up until it retraces up until this point, depending on the point that it ends to retrace. But as long as you see that this is an engulfing, then you take a trade. Your stop loss is just above, and then you're targeting the market to push to the downside, like I said on the first one. Let me just clone this. Sorry about that. So you expect the market to push to the downside. And then another thing, guys, it does not wait around. The market does not wait around when you get like this type of formation in right areas. In the right areas, it does not wait around. It just pushes to the downside, and then you get like your take profit hit. Let me just show you like the candlestick formation that I'm talking about now. And then we have this area here. Let me just check. Is it in line with everything? Okay, this is the engulfing candlestick pattern to the downside. As you can see, we have this area here. The stop loss is just above this point. And then, like I said, guys, we wait for this red candle to close. After the red candle closes, then that is when we take the trade. As you can see, we have a less drawdown. We didn't get any drawdown. And then you take profit that's around 7% if you're targeting like the previous low or previous highs. As you can see here, we have the overall 9% take profit. So that is how like I use like this evening, this engulfing candlestick pattern. So this one is for the downside or the bearish candlestick formation, and then the bearish engulfing, and then let's switch to the bullish engulfing now. So let me just look for a picture perfect one, just because some of you so let me just use like this one here at the lows like this. As you can see, people are caught in the wrong side also around this point, and then we have that engulfing happening very nicely. Let me just do this. Let me just check for my tools. So this is the area that I'm talking about around this point. As you can see, we are targeting the previous highs. As you can see, we have like 5 point something%. So you can just use like patterns all the time. You can just use like these patterns, candlestick patterns when you're trading, have it in chart. That's what I'm trying to accomplish at the moment. I'm trying to take as many trades on clean charts as possible, guys. So this is the area also. As you can see, we have a bullish engulfing also around this point. So you had like another chance to take a trade. Let's say you had like this type of area here as your break come and retest, and then you take the entry, let's say around this point after it closes. Then your stop loss is just below this area here, just to give this low an area to a swing so that you can just be in the trade. And then this is the area you're targeting for 4%. So guys, those are the patterns that I focus on, candlestick patterns that I focus on. And then another candlestick pattern that I focus on is this one here. So on this scenario here, we have the morning star and the evening star, as you can see here. And then, as I always say, guys, we wait for this type of candlestick confirmation to form up in a high value area. Let's say this is a high value area whereby the market tapped this area twice. Let's say we have this type of price action. Let me just do this. We had like this type of price action. And then, as you can see here, this could be like a value area just because we have some type of a double top at the top of the structure. And then this wick creation here shows that the buyers are losing momentum and then sellers are getting into the market. So what you wait for is for this candlestick formation to finish up. And then what I'm emphasizing is that you wait for this red candle to finish up and then engulf this green one around this point. And then whenever it finishes closing, that is when you take your sell entry. And then your stop loss is just above this area here, whereby it's an area of confluence or in a high point of value. So your stop loss is just above, and then you're targeting the lows. Simple as that, guys. This is the evening star, and then this is how you use it. And then I'll show you on the charts just how it forms up and all of that stuff. And then the morning star, same in reverse, guys. The market has been pushing to the downside. And then when you get this wick creation, just know that the sellers are losing momentum. You'll see that by this candle wick creation. And then what you wait for is for this green candle to form up. And then let's say it's around this point, you don't take a trade up until it closes up above, and then you take your buy at the top of the structure, and then your stop loss is just below. You can just use this wick creation as your stop loss, and then this is your stop loss boundary. And then you targeting the highs wherever you see like it's a previous high or a previous low, that's where you take your profits. And then depending on your RR, guys, are you taking a 1-2-3 or a 1-2-2 all the time so that you can be in the right side of your risk management? So this is how I use like the evening star and the morning star. So let me just show you like on the charts so that you can get to understand what I'm talking about, guys. Now, and then each and everything that I talked about like on this video, just know that it happens on every time frame, né? On the hour, on the daily, the 4 hour, each and every time frame, guys. Just know that it happens in all time frames. So now let me just show you like those candlestick formations in live charts. Let me just check around this point. Check. Just check. So we are on the 4 hour at the moment. I'm just trying to find where I can just get like a clear one whereby you can just understand the thought process of everything. So in this area here, you can see that we have that green candle, we have the wick creation, we have that red candle closing below, like I said. And then what you do is that you take the entry just below the close, your stop loss is just above. And then, as you can see, we get like that momentum to the downside. It pushes to the downside with less drawdown, guys. As you can see, less drawdown. And then that is what we aim for all the time. I know that some of the trade can be in like some losses for a few minutes, and then you get like into profits in that few minutes. And then, as you can see here, I was illustrating the evening stars, the evening star. So now we have the morning star, as you can see here, push to the downside, and then we have that low momentum, and then you get this weak creation. After the weak creation, just know that we get like that a green candle, as I said, to get like that confirmation, as you can see around this point here. Your stop loss is just below, even on this one, as you can see. You're using like the lows as your stop loss. And then as you can see on this one, you could have been tagged out, but like you didn't get tagged out, depending on like a broker that you're using. And then I have like the best brokers, guys, in the description below. You can just choose one that suits your plan or suits your style of trading, and then just go with it, guys. Even a prop firm, you can just use like prop firms. And as you can see here, even if you are targeting like the highs and all of that stuff, you're targeting maybe this high here, then you'll know that you are in a good trade. You have like 5.3%. And then this type of candlestick formations work on all pairs. You can find them on NASDAQ, on USDT, on currencies. You can find them on your futures and all of that stuff, guys. Yeah. So that is it for today's video, and then I hope you enjoyed this nice video that I tried to create for you guys. Just appreciate like my work by clicking the like button, by subscribing, and then by dropping a comment of how you are enjoying the content so far, guys. So we are 360 uploads in at the moment, so I think we'll reach like 1K uploads this year. So I'll see you on another video, guys. Shop, shop.